Doubt is anything but beneficial when officials officially use the benefit of the doubt to make you doubt the victim and believe the criminal. How dare you make this about black and white when it's Freddie Gray? How dare you make this about pigment when it's Michael Brown? How dare you make this about colors? Trayvon Skittles wouldn't approve. Anybody and everybody always tries to type a text body about the ways a black body coulda, woulda, shoulda to not have gotten body. Like maybe, during the conversation with her killer, Sandra coulda made the talk less bland. Shoulda put on her cigarettes, shoulda put out her cigarettes as well as the fire in her heart. In the officer's eyes, should not have saw the reflection of Rekia Boyd. Eric Gardner should have shaped up in the social pyramid. Selling loose squares in a cop circle? Eric was trying to give the cop cancer. Secondhand smoke poisoned his oxygen. Jordan Davis banging music in his car playing playlists. Probably bunking gang lyrics, we know he's affiliated. Should have turned down the volume before he was muted. Then Michael Dunn's gun went a boom like an 808 kick. 7-year-old Ayanna Jones was napping during the police raid. The officers just wanted to help. The bullet was the perfect sleep aid. 12-year-old Samir holding a pellet gun on sight. Caucasian officer stuck into Samir. I call that white on rice. Darren Wilson stated that while grabbing Michael Brown, that he felt like a 5-year-old holding on to Hulk Hogan. Guess that explains the raw smackdown and the 400-year-old rigged fight and all the rules broken. Could have handcuffed them and sent them to a cage match. 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1 shots and he's down on the mat. Took Mike's championship belt, then wonder why he sags. Maybe that's why it's so easy to put a cap in his ass. Everybody seems more concerned with what a black victim wore rather than the fact that an aggressor proposed war. Does crime have a dress code? Are urban wardrobe urban war clothes? Do they show I'm not resisting or are parts of the resistance? If blacks didn't wear t-shirts and snapbacks, then 6 officers would leave Freddie Gray with his back snapped. As if a blazer keeps vigilantes from having me blaze. As if I didn't wear a do-rag, then I wouldn't still make waves. An officer can still use my work tie as a noose. So when my homicide is labeled suicide, it becomes the proof. Only law enforcement knows how to make a garbage bag fashionable. Like dress suits won't be replaced with an orange one. But Madonna is still voguing without them being gang signs. But Macklemore is still popping tags without getting popped. Blacks have had their lips challenged for years, but Kylie Jenner still gets the credit. But Justin Bieber still smoking reefer. But Miley still twerking. But Iggy still fancy. But Will Ferrell can still act in the movie with Kevin Hart. Get hard. America has a hard on for the same cultures that it leaves sterile. White America still cash cropping my cornrows. Just admit that you think my melanin is malevolent, marked as a target whenever it isn't marked as marketable. But suburban white kids still use an African American vernacular. It seems our tongues are beloved until we bare our fangs, because they still not thugs. Because I'm sure you'll tell my skin what it could have done to be more Caucasian. I mean more human. No, what's the difference? Thank you.